My name is Fedor Sandalov, and I'm a PhD student of Mineralogical Department of Geological Faculty, Moscow State University. My report is a short review of evolutionary ideas in mineralogical science. Well, it's a quite modern problem and has been developed by outstanding authors, as Russian researchers, as American.
Good morning, dear colleagues. Today, I would like to tell you about one old new concept in the study of mineralogy. My report is a short review of evolutionary ideas in the mineralogical world. So, I allowed myself to convert the main idea into a simple question. Do minerals evolve? To answer it, we will have to find out keys to other questions. First, we need to define what exactly mineral is and how many mineral species are known in nature, on Earth or on extraterrestrial bodies. Second, we need to look into the history of the development of mineral evolution ideas and see what concepts are in progress now. Then, we shall define one of the ideas, and after that, I'll show you different consequences of mineral evolution process and also show a list of references about the topic at the end. What is a mineral? It's not a simple question. Some geologists may say that the term mineral has dozens of definitions and they are all incorrect. But in the study of mineralogy, we've got two considerations about mineral and mineral species
currently proposed by International Mineralogical Association, IMA. Thus, a mineral is a solid that has natural occurrence and form due to natural conditions. A mineral species is a mineral with well-defined crystallographic properties and stable mineral composition. Also, it has a name. For example, from this slide, you can see mineral species halite, sodium chloride with cubic structure and found there in evaporite deposits. Nevertheless, you can see also a mark, a question that marks uncertainties and difficulties of this classification, as well as any other classification case. But it's a topic of another report. Commission on New Minerals Nomenclature and Classification of the IMA presents a list of approved minerals on its site. Well, there are 5,688 mineral species on this list. Using the data, I created a graph that demonstrates a gradual increase with some peaks in the number of mineral species over the last 20 years. It's also important to note that 4% of all mineral species were investigated by geologists from MSU. Let's take a look at the term of evolution. In a very general sense, evolution is a change over time. Any evolutionary process can be marked with three signs, such as complexity, diversity, and congruency. On the one hand, we are all aware of the biological evolutionary theory. On the other hand, we know about historical evolution of our planet. What about mineral species? Is there a place for them in this Earth-life cycle of evolution? The first strong attempts to develop evolutionary ideas in mineralogy were provided by outstanding Soviet Russian mineralogists Arkady Zhadin and Nikolai Yushkin. More than 40 years ago, Zhadin wrote an article, "Is there evolution of mineral species on Earth?" This article represents a description of mineral evolution in detail. Zhadin formulated three stages of mineral formation: meteorite, basalt, and crust. Also, he divided minerals into three types using time as a criterion: panchronic, monochronic, and polychronic minerals. Both Yushkin and Zhadin suggested that the quantity and complexity of minerals is rising throughout geological history. Moreover, usually applied math approaches to evaluate evolution, mineral evolution in mineral systems. The most important thing that these evolutionary ideas were amplified and expanded by Russian and American mineralogists later in the present century. The first article was published in 2008. It's called simple mineral evolution by the Robert Hazen group. This article represents the most detailed and extensive description of the mineral evolution process. After that, Sergei Krivovichev and Vladimir Krivovichev wrote articles about structural complexity of minerals and the evolution of mineral systems. The investigations of these two groups have been going on, displaying fascinating results for mineralogical science. In this part of the presentation, we will discuss evolutionary ideas prepared by the Robert Hazen group. So, they suggested 3 eras of mineral evolution. It's considered that before evolution, there was a time before evolution, only so-called ore minerals existed in space. Then, planetary accretion initiated 4.55 billion years ago. The second era is an early Earth period of evolution. And the last era is caused by the appearance and development of life on the Earth. Let's run through each of them. Approximately a few hundred million years after the Big Bang event, the most primary minerals must have formed in expanding gaseous envelopes of supernovas or early generations of stars. During two events at minimum, like HEB stars or core collapse of supernovas, dozens of primary refractory minerals formed, containing only 11 essential chemical elements. There are 12 ore minerals in total. They represent different compounds, native elements, carbides, nitrides, oxides, etc. The most probable first mineral in the universe was diamond. Then it's turned into graphite after cobalt. Also, you can see more complex compounds like silicates, etc. By the way, all of these primary minerals can be identified by their anomalous isotopic composition. The next step toward mineral evolution is mineral dust gathering in star-forming regions, nebulas. Here, mineral evolution begins. And also, in these nebulas, accretion of planetesimals carried out. During the accretion, the primary accretion of planetesimals, first meteorites, chondral meteorites form. They contain chondrules, which consist of different minerals, for example, magnesium silicates, like olivine. Also, they contain calcium aluminium inclusions that consist of a number of minerals that are given in this table. It has been found that in all types of chondrites, there are 60 distinct minerals. As planetesimal accretion progressed and the chondrite parent bodies began to become larger, new minerals formed due to aqueous alteration or thermal alteration of these bodies. Also, there were processes like melting and differentiation of planetesimals, which led to formation of achondrite or ironstone meteorites or iron meteorites. All of these meteorites preserve about 250 minerals. These minerals are dominated by magnesium silicate, sulfides, and iron nickel metals. It's a raw material for the next accretion of the Earth and other planets. The initial period of Earth crust evolution depended on different types of geochemical and petrological processes like volcanism, degasing, fractional crystallization, contact and regional metamorphism, and plate tectonics, and etc. Well, more than 1,500 minerals formed due to these processes. Also, these processes can be divided into stages. Igneous rock evolution produced various magmatic minerals like pyroxenes or feldspars, then granite and pegmatite formation generated, it's important, minerals of rare elements like tourmaline, lepidolite, or beryl. After that, plate tectonics produced sulfides or sulfur salts and also took out some metamorphic minerals on the Earth's surface. And the anoxicological world generated carbonate reefs and iron banded formations. An anoxic biological world had a little effect on mineralogical diversity. That situation changed with the biological inhalation, oxygen photosynthesis by cyan bacteria, which also formed stromatolite formations. When the level of oxygen rose, or may have risen more than 1% of modern levels, the Great Exudation event irreversibly transformed Earth's surface mineralogy. More than 2,500 minerals were oxidized and hydrated with the products of other minerals. Well, the next stage, the intermediate ocean, is a stasis period of mineral evolution. These novel Earth events produced cap carbonates and clay minerals started to be generated. And the last era was caused by living organisms. They used carbonate, phosphate, or silica as skeleton constituents. Also, the roles of plants changed Earth's surface, soils formed, and new production of clay minerals appeared. And in total, we got more than 5,000 minerals. Let me show you some examples of the life-mineral interaction. Just look at these beautiful marine creatures. They use quite rare minerals like greenlight or attacamite as part of their bodies. Biomineralization for them is a strategy to enhance the hardness or stiffness of their tissues. They considered different eras and stages of mineral evolution process. In this graph, the stages of time plotted against the number of minerals. It can be seen that the number of minerals at first increased gradually up to the stage number 7. And then the Great Exudation event happened and the dramatic increase appeared. After that, the small increase observed, which is caused by life. Mineral evolution has been driven by several factors. The first is basic separation and concentration of chemical elements in solar nebulas. The second, the increase of the range of intensive parameters such as pressure, temperature and activities of water or carbon dioxide. And the third and the last, the creation of new mineral forming environments by living organisms. Also, mineral evolution has its own trends. Researchers observed that the mineral pulses of mineralization correlate with the stages of supercontinent cycle. Also, the average exudation state of some minerals is increasing, as well as chemical and structural complexity of minerals through geological time. The last process is shown in this bar chart. From ore minerals, number one, horizontal axis, to post-Hadean minerals, number four, both structural and chemical complexity is increasing. This complexity is evaluated with modified Shannon formula, which requires data about symmetry of minerals and the number of atoms in their unit cell. Examples are given in the table. By the way, the most complex mineral on Earth is aegmatite. It's a secondary uranium mineral with beautiful yellow crystals, which is about 50 micrometers in size. Let's return to our main question. Do minerals evolve? The evidence seems to be support the idea, so yes. What are the implications of this mineral evolution process? First, it will allow teaching mineralogy in the aspects of Earth or even the universe history. Second, it may help to modify the present mineral classification principles. Recently, Robert Hedding has proposed to add the evolutionary component to mineral classification description of mineral species. Because of some minerals like pyrite or calcite or diamond have different chemical and physical properties depending on their genesis. For instance, the kinds of diamond differ greatly from each other in size, morphology or isotopic composition. And should we just call it diamond steel, or should we add pre-solar or impact prefixes to diamond? It's an open question. If you want for more details, you can go to the list of references I share with you. That's all. Thanks for your attention.